Blessings upon blessings. Welcome to Promises Kept Ministry. I am Minister Deborah, and I will be bringing forth the word today. Let's just head right into prayer. Father God, we just want to thank you for this time, Father Lord Jesus. We want to thank you that you are present on this service today, Lord. I declare and decree, Father Lord God, that every heart is open to receive. Every ear can hear, Father, Lord God, and every mind be renewed, Lord, to what it is that you have for them today, Lord. We want to thank you, Father, Lord God, for the word says that you go before us and you prepare the way, Father, Lord Jesus. Let this word come from your lips, Father, Lord God, through my voice, Father, Lord Jesus, and unto your people. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Now, if you would turn with me to John 10:10. And the word reads, a thief has only one thing in mind. He wants to steal, slaughter, and destroy. But I have come to give you everything in abundance, more than you expect, life in its fullness, until you overflow. The title of today's message is the Itis. Why did I name it the Itis, you ask? Because with Thanksgiving just finishing up, you became overflowed in your belly with all the food that you enjoyed. And not only did you become overflowed on that one day, you continue days after. So what I'm going to be speaking about today is the overflow of the Lord Jesus Christ. I want you to have the itis in the Lord. I want you to be full of his word, full of his presence, full in prayer, full in abundance, full lacking nothing. That's what I want for you today. Now turn with me to Psalms 1, verse 3. He will be standing firm like a flourishing tree, planted by God's design, deeply rooted by the brooks of bliss, bearing fruit in every season of life. He is never dry, never fainting, ever blessed, ever prosperous. He is standing firm, flourishing, planted in God's design. God wants you to know that you are planted in his design, that he knows what it is that you are going through. He knows what it is that you are facing in today's world, but you are still planted in his design. You are still a child of God. And he wants us to get to a place where we're rooted in him each and every day. Each and every day. There's a world full of doubt out there, but you are a child of God. You are planted in him. You are rooted in the Spirit of the Lord. Jesus Christ took residency through the Holy Spirit in you. You shall fail not. Psalms 1, go up two verses. What delight comes to the one who follows God's way? He won't walk in the step of the wicked, nor share the sinner's way, nor be found sitting on scorching seat. His passion is to remain true to the word of I am, meditating day and night on the true revelation of the light. The Lord delights in you. Say it with me. The Lord delights in me. My passion remains in the great I am. Declare it over your life, over your children, over your home, over everything that concerns you. Declare it. Because when you are planted in Him, you will not wither. You will not doubt. Your faith will not look to the left or to the right. Because on Christ, the solid rock, you stand. Joel 2, starting at verse 23. And when I read this text, I want you to say your name. Rejoice, you, Deborah. Rejoice in your Lord, in the Lord your God. For the rain He sends demonstrates His faithfulness. Once more, the autumn rain will come, as well as the rain of spring. The threshing floor will again be piled high with grain, and the presses will overflow with new wine and olive oil. God wants your cup to run over. God doesn't want you in drought any longer. He wants you to apply the word of overflow in your life. He wants you to get tired of being tired of the same old thing. Take a moment, think about it. What cycle in your life keeps repeating itself? What thing keeps happening over and over again? What's happening with your finances? What's happening with your job? What's happening in your household, in your relationships, in your intimate relationship with the Lord? Has nothing changed? Is it still the same thing over and over again? Today, God wants to overflow your life with His goodness. He wants to fill your cup. So whatever is depleting in your life, declare an overflow and new wine today. Isaiah 43. But now, Deborah, listen to the Lord who created you. Oh, Deborah, the one who framed you says, do not be afraid, for I have ransomed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. When you go through deep waters, I will be with you. When you go through rivers of difficulties, I will be with you. When you go through rivers, when you walk through the fires of oppression, you will not be burned up. The flames will not consume you. Something just happened when I said that. There was a breakthrough in the spiritual realm. So I'm going to repeat it again. And when I repeat it again, I want you to say your name once more. But now, O Deborah, listen to the Lord who created you. O Deborah, the one who formed you says, do not be afraid, for I have ransomed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. When you go through deep waters, I will be with you. When you go through rivers of difficulties, you will not drown. When you walk through the fires of oppression, you will not burn up. The flames will not consume you. Receive that today. Receive it today in your life. Only God knows what you are carrying on your shoulders. Only God knows what has oppressed you in this week. Only God knows your feelings. Only God knows your situation. Go to Him with everything that matters. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One, your Savior. I gave Egypt as a ransom for your freedom. I gave Jesus as a ransom for your freedom. Others were given in exchange for you. I traded Jesus' life for yours because you are my precious one. You are honored and I love you. You see, the word of the Lord needs to be applied to us. We need to apply it to our lives in everything that we do. That's why we have the word of God. We have it so that it can teach us, so that it can lead us, so that it can guide us, so that it can give us wisdom. And God wants us to get to a point that we're no longer acting or behaving or living as the old man. If the word of God tells us that Jesus Christ died on the cross for us and that our sins are forgiven and that a new day has come and that He takes place within us, why are we still living in the old way? Why have we not taken up our cross and follow Him? Why are we not believing Him when He says that He has a way out for us? He has a way out of addiction. He has a way out of pornography. He has a way out of alcoholism. He has a way out of prostitution. He has a way out of poverty. He has a way out of homelessness. He has a way out of all things. And yet here we are declaring that we are children of God, living the same way that He met us, that we met Him. And you have to come to a place. And I pray that that place and that time is today. That you stand your ground against the enemy. And you tell him that he cannot have it anymore. That you are no longer going to entertain it. You are no longer going to receive it in your life. You are no longer going to accept it. That's the place that I want you to get to today. That's the place that the Lord wants you. Because then He is able to pour into you until you overflow in your life. Little by little, step by step. Verse 10. But you are my witness, O Deborah, says the Lord. You are my servant. You have been chosen to know me. Believe in me and understand that I alone am God. There is no other. There has never been, and there never will be. I, yes, I, the Lord, There is no other savior. There's no one else. There's no one else that is going to do for you what he had done and will continue to do in your life. There's no one else that is going to love you more. There's no one else that is going to care for you more. There is no one else that is going to provide for you more than him. See, human nature, the world will tell you that they need to give you your finances, that you need to find a way to make more, that that's their success. But as Jay-Z once said, more money, more problems. And like we just heard, that you will never see a U-Haul behind a hearse. You will never see it. People are chasing things that will not bring them joy, that will not bring them happiness, that will not bring them peace, that will not bring them a sound mind. And God wants to eliminate that. It's not about how much you can get. It's about how much you can give. Just think about it. It's not about how much you can get. Because the word says that money is the root of all evil. But where does that start? It starts in the heart. You think you don't have enough. So you're chasing and you're chasing for more, more, and more. And where has that gotten you? And money's not the only thing we're chasing after. Some of us are chasing after love, acceptance. Some of us are chasing after relationships, jobs. Have you consulted with the Lord before taking a step forward? Or is God telling you to stand still and wait on him, and you've gone far ahead? Because sometimes we think that we know best, when the word of the Lord tells us that his ways are not our ways. His understanding are not our understanding. When we move by faith, we don't see what's next. You're moving, trusting the Lord. And I know that for myself, I am ready to be in the overflow. I am ready to have the itis in him. I am ready to gain whatever weight I need to gain as long as it's with him, as long as it's for him, for him and his glory, for him and the kingdom of God. First, I predicted your rescue. Then I saved you and proclaimed it to the world. No foreign God has ever done this. You are witness that I am the only God, says the Lord. From eternity to eternity, I am God. No one can snatch anyone out of my hand. No one can undo what I have done. No one, the enemy, cannot take you out of the Lord's hands. no one can undo what Jesus Christ did on the cross. You received him as your Lord and Savior. You confessed it with your lips. No sin in the world can separate you. No, not one. Your sins are forgiven, past, present, and future. This is why we're reading it in the Word. From eternity to eternity, he is God. From your beginning to the end, he is God. Verse 25. I alone will blot out your sins for my own sake, and I will never think of them again. Let us review the situation together, and you can present your case to prove your innocence. You know what your innocence is? The blood of Jesus. The death of Jesus Christ. That's what proves your innocence. Because he says here, he won't remember them again. He won't. He doesn't. God is not an accuser. He doesn't continue to accuse you of what you used to do, of what you did before. He doesn't accuse us. So when you feel like you're being condemned and shamed, and you feel that guilt, that is the enemy. Because he says here, I alone will blot out your sins for my own sake. He's not doing it for nothing else but for himself and his name and what he is defined as. That's why it follows with, let's review the situation together. And you can present your case to prove your innocence. And your innocence is Jesus Christ, the mediator. He's the one that goes before the Lord on your behalf. He's the one that presented the case before God. And he said, by my stripes, she is healed. By my stripes, he is forgiven. James 1, starting at verse 5. And if anyone longs to be wise, ask God for wisdom, and he will give it. He won't see your lack of wisdom as an opportunity to scorn you over your failures, but he will overwhelm your failures with his generous grace. You see, he's not an accuser. Just make sure you ask, empowered by confident faith, without doubting that you will receive. For the oblivious person believes 1 minute and doubts the next. Being undecided makes you become like the rough sea, driven and tossed by the wind. You're up 1 minute and tossed down the next. That's our feelings right there. That is our feelings right there. Some of us feel like this daily. 1 minute we know the Lord loves us and that he died on the cross for us and that we're forgiven of our sins. The next minute, we're living in the guilt, shame, doubt, condemnation. When I'm showing you the scriptures that says, he won't hold them against you. He does not hold the past against you. And your past could mean an hour ago, 10 minutes ago, right before you got on this Zoom, right before you prepared yourself to receive this word. Only he knows. Only he knows. When you are half-hearted and wavering, it leaves you unstable. Can you really expect to receive anything from the Lord when you are in that condition? When you are in this condition, like James 1 speaks of, we make our life difficult. God wants to give us, but we can receive it in the fullness and the overflow because we doubt it. If you're asking God for financial increase and you doubt it, how can you receive one penny extra? How are we going to ask God for $1 million and not know what we're going to do with that $1 million? How can we receive it? We heard before that we need to plan. We need to have it written down. We need to have a vision, like the word says. The word says, without a vision, my people perish. Have you been writing down your dreams? Have you been writing down what the Lord has been speaking to your life? Have you been setting goals daily? See, God doesn't want you to start in 2022. He doesn't want you to start with a New Year's resolution. That is not who God is. God is ready to start today. God is ready to start pouring into you today till it overflows. And when it overflows, he wants you to look for someone else that you can pour into. Let's not live the selfish life about me, me, me. That is not the way the Lord Jesus Christ taught us to live. You see, in his last prayer to the Lord, he said, let not my will be done, but let your will be done. And right before that, he asked God to take this cup from him that he was about to bear. But not my will, Lord, your will. So you look into someone that you can pour into when your cup starts to overflow. If your faith remains strong, even while surrendered by life's difficulties, you will continue to experience the untold blessings of God. True happiness comes when you pass the test with faith and receive the victorious crown of life promised to every lover of God. When you are tempted, don't ever say, God is tempting me, for God is incapable of being tempted by evil. He is never the source of temptation. Instead, it is each person's own desires and thoughts that drag them into evil and lure them away into darkness. He's incapable of tempting you. It's not in his nature. It's not who he is. He is incapable. It is your own desires and your own thoughts. Think about that. What are you thinking? What are you saying to yourself? Because in the mind, in the thoughts, is where the enemy goes to work. Psalms 23, and I'll end here. Yahweh is my best friend and my shepherd. I always have more than enough. He offers a resting place for me in his luxurious love. His tracks take me to an oasis of peace near the quiet brooks of bliss. That's where he restores and revives my life. He opens before me the right path and leads me along in his footsteps of righteousness so that I can bring honor to his name. Even when your path takes me through the valley of deepest darkness, fear will never conquer me, for you already have. Your authority is my strength and my peace. The comfort of your love takes away my fear. I'll never be lonely, for you are near. You become my delicious feast. Even when my enemies dare to fight, you anoint me with the fragrance of your Holy Spirit. You give me all I can drink of you until my cup overflows. You anoint me with the fragrance of your Holy Spirit. You give me all that I can drink of you until my cup overflows. God wants you to bathe in his Holy Spirit today. He wants to drench you in his presence. He wants to anoint your head with his oil until it hits the bottom of your foot. He wants to take you to new places in him. He wants to be your God over all. He wants you to overflow in his word and in your prayer. He wants you to be dedicated to him as much as you are dedicated to the works he called you to do. He wants you to be so dedicated to him as much as you dedicate yourself to the television or entertaining others or doing for others, because it's about him. It needs to be about him. It needs to be about his presence in your life. It needs to be about the person he called you to be. Everything else doesn't go with you. You don't go to take account before the Lord and tell him what you have done. You don't get to point out all your successes. You don't get to point out all the money that you have given. You don't get to point out all the money that you've received. No, the word says that he will take account. You have no idea what he is going to tell you when you get to that place. So stop looking at what you're doing and start looking at what you're doing. Yes, I just said it. Stop looking at what you are doing and start looking at what you are doing. Is it beneficial? Is it beneficial to you? Is it beneficial to others? Is it beneficial to the Lord? We really have to start looking at what it is that we're doing. We really have to start looking and asking ourselves, is this beneficial to me? Is this what God really wants me to do at this time on this day? Because he will put a stop to it if it's not beneficial. I declare that over our lives, that God will put a stop to the things that we think are beneficial and are not in our lives. Why? Because we have to come to a place where God is all we seek day and night. Where Jesus Christ is all we are worried about. All that we are seeking. Everything else will fall into place. Nothing missing, nothing lacking. Everything else will fall into place. He wants you to live by faith and not by sight. He wants you to be so rooted in him that nothing else matters. He wants your mind renewed. He wants your heart healed. He wants you whole. He wants you whole. It's not about waiting until later. It's not about starting tomorrow. It's about taking a hold of it now. So why would I fear the future? Only goodness and tender love pursues me all the days of my life. Then afterward, when my life is through, I will return to your glorious presence to be forever with you. Only goodness and tender love pursues you. Nothing bad, nothing cruel, nothing damaging, no disturbance. That is not who God is. That is not why Jesus Christ died on the cross for you. Take an identity to that death that he bore on the cross. I think once we start to identify with that death, and understanding that he died for me, that he died for you. Believe it or not, your identity starts there. The word says that he died once for all to blot out our sins so that we can be able to call on the name of Jesus at any given time, and he is there. He is ready and willing to execute whatever it is that you need. You just have to receive it. No disability, no disorder, no label. Nothing can take its place. Nothing can take the place of the cross. I can't tell the Lord I'm disabled. I can't do that. No, that is not who he is. The word of God says that he equips us and he calls us and he prepares us. So if I'm doing a thing, it is because he has equipped me, he has called me, and he has prepared me. My disability has nothing to do with it. It is out of the equation. So don't look at the names that you have been called. Don't look at the words that have been spoken against your life. Don't look at the fingers that have been pointed. Don't look at the labels people have put on you. He is God, and he is God alone. Nothing more nothing less. Prepare yourself to start living in the overflow because it is coming. There is an overflow coming into your life and you are ready to receive it. Do not sit down in your chair with your arms crossed. Take a stand today with your arms open wide and prepare yourself for the overflow because it is coming. I declare these things over your life. And I declare everything good that is coming with it. No New Year's resolution is going to be able to compare to what God is going to start doing in your life starting today. This week, I want you to take these three books in the Bible and just meditate on them as the Lord continues to prepare you for his overflow. Psalms 23. Isaiah 43 and James 1. Just dedicate 5 minutes of your time every day. And I'm going to do the same. And I'm going to read these scriptures over and over again because he is going to prepare us for his overflow. Weeks from now and months from now, we are going to be talking about the itis that we have of his goodness. Amen and amen. Now I leave you with Minister Ivalice with tithes and offering.
Amen. So we're going to go on 2 Chronicles 31, verse 4 through 5. He ordered the people living in Jerusalem to give the portion due to priests and Levites, so they could devote themselves to the law of the Lord. As soon as the order went out, the Israelites generously gave the first fruit of their grain, new wine, olive oil, and honey, and all that the field produced. They brought a great amount at tithes of everything. Now, the Lord knows how important tithes are. In the Bible, there are 800 verses of tithes. The importance of tithes are to help his church grow and to help the poor and those who need help. A friend of mine was very sick and she was not able to work. So she spoke with her pastor about her health that put her in a situation where she could not pay her rent. A blessing from the Lord was given to my friend and the church paid her rent. Now, for anyone who would like to give their tithes or offerings to Promises Kept Ministry, please see the screen with the important information, or you can use Cash App Promises Kept Ministry, or PayPal at Promises Kept Ministry. Now we're going to take a few moments to listen to our offering song.
What if smartphones were more than just smart? The all-new Google Pixel 6, with a 24-hour adaptive battery that sends power precisely where you need it. Google Pixel 6.
Put.
Raindrops rolling off my brim. Street lights got the pavement glistening. Touchdown, I fall into your arms. Right where I belong, your everlasting arms. And where would I be without you?
feet back in my bag when I need to stay. I'll be chasing every breeze that blows my way. I'll be building my kingdom just to watch it fade away. It's true, that's me without you. Ooh, 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 ooh. That's me without you.
I am Minister Lisa, and I would love to close the prayer for today's service. So, Lord, thank God for everything that you have done for us. We are all still here. We are all still intact. We're just waiting for your call to just let us know what it is that you want us to do and to just guide us in the directions where we need to be. If we do fall and fumble, it's okay. As long as you give us the strength and the will to just get back on that and just continue to move forward, continue to just guide us and love us, because it is greatly needed. So for all who have issues or need to release some of those issues, all you got to do is just call upon the Lord, and the Lord will give you the answers. He will give you the questions that you need to be answered for. So just keep guiding and keep just moving forward and just keep pushing and ask the Lord, whatever it is that you need, ask for it, because he will receive. Because it says that he will give you whatever that you ask for. And it's very simple to do. I know that for some it's hard, but sometimes we have to push forward, and we just have to alleviate some of those stresses and alleviate some of those memories of pain and just give it to him. Give it to him so that you can find that peace and that you can continue to walk the walk that he wants you to walk, to be the better you, the best you. So in Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen.